But the last and major part, all these things are entirely covered by cerebrum, or cerebral cortex. Now, if you see our brain, will be of two lobes. The two lobes are hemispheres. They are known as hemispheres. Left hemisphere, right hemisphere. The top thing, the complete convolutions, is called as cerebral cortex. So the entire part, inside you have all these parts are there, but the top covering is nothing but cerebral cortex. They have sulcus, a separation is there. So that is the reason why they are considered as left hemisphere and right hemisphere. Understand this. Now cerebral cortex, the cerebral cortex has got a unique ability. The left hemisphere is responsible for reading, writing, and mathematics skills. Reading, writing, mathematics skills are under the control of this left hemisphere. The right hemisphere is responsible for imagination, creative thinking. You know, all the creative people are supposed to have very highly developed right brain. Rajamouli, a creative director, has got very good of this right brain. Now, the uniqueness of brain is it can act independently or it can act in combination. What do I mean by that? Understand this. See, during my school days, my school teachers used to say a word for students, that is body present, mind absent. What do you mean by that? Body present, mind absent means, think about this. See, when teachers are teaching, some of the students will be writing, but they don't write it consciously. They'll be writing passively, but they'll be thinking something else. What is happening? Think about this. When I'm teaching, when you are listening, if you feel some points are important, you will start writing. When you start writing, reading, writing, mathematics, arithmetic skills are under the control of your left hemisphere. When you start writing, your left hemisphere is highly active. Now, while writing, if you start imagining about brain, if I'm explaining about brain, if you started thinking about brain, that means looking with your brain eye. You know, Naidu sir keeps saying that, looking with your brain eye. So when you start writing something, your left part is acting. And at the same time, if you think about brain, the imagination, the right part, both of them are acting on a single point. Taking notes, thinking about the subject, that combination will give you concentration. That is what is concentration is. But certain students, they'll be writing, but their imagination part will be somewhere else. It is with Aishwarya Rai, Amitabh Bachchan, somewhere else. It goes to movie, it goes to home, it goes on a vacation. It happens, you can write without thinking about the words, your imagination goes somewhere else. If that happens, they are not working together. They are dissociated, right? You're writing something, but imagination is somewhere else. That is what loosely called as body present, mind absent. So what are they talking? They're talking your left brain is present because you're writing. Mind absent means your right brain has gone somewhere else. And this is the ability of this cerebrum. Cerebral cortex can work together. When it is working together, that is what gives us concentration. The ability to concentrate on a subject comes when you can combine both of them. If both of them are dissociated, you don't have any concentration. That is a major problem with all of us. In order to concentrate, you need to bring back your right brain. The imagination is very, very cranky when it goes somewhere else. You need to pull it back. Think about this. When you are listening to a class for 1 hour, how do you feel? 2 hours, 3 hours, 3 hours class continuously if someone is taking. How much you will be able to retain? Very few, right? Very few will retain a lot of the information. Majority cannot concentrate much. What about a movie? Movie is for 3 hours. You sit in a movie, 3 hours, with a break, one break, interval, and then you watch that. You remember a lot of things from the movie. Even you have seen a movie, a 10 years ago movie, still you remember everything. What is happening there? The cerebral cortex is working completely. You see a particular scene, you involve in that. If hero is fighting there, your hands will clench like this. If heroine is laughing there, you will laugh with her. So what is happening? The complete involvement is there. Left brain as well as right brain. You see something, you involve, imagine, that is what gives you concentration. When you concentrate on something, it will be there in our long-term memory. It will be not in hippocampal, which is short-term memory. It goes to the cerebral cortex. That is where is the seat of long-term memory. So in order to get long-term memory, one, the ability to concentrate is required. Second one, the ability to repeat the things. When you keep doing something repeatedly, it gets into your long-term memory. You know about movie songs. Whenever your favorite song comes, you keep humming it. So when it is repeated, it gets into your long-term memory. You don't forget about it. That is what happens. You know about our national anthems? No one by heart our national anthems. When you get into the school, everyone sings the national anthem. So without by hearting, it gets into your brain because you do it repeatedly, hence it gets into your long-term memory. All these are with our cerebral cortex. In fact, our intelligence is based on how you use your cerebral cortex. I'll give you one more practical example. When we are all born with a creative mind. The right brain is highly active. Observe the kids, young children. When they start talking, they will ask a lot of questions. What is this? What is that? 2 days ago, I was traveling and it was raining. So in front of my seat, a small boy was sitting there. He was asking, who is pouring water from the top? He thinks rain, someone is pouring water. So his father said, no, it is called rain. Then he said, what is rain? Father said, water coming down from the sky is rain. What is sky? He keeps on explaining. The boy is not stopping. Everything is his question. It is there with all small children. We all have very creative, powerful minds. We keep questioning everything. The problem comes when parents could not answer properly, they will not encourage kids to ask questions. Even worse, when kids get into the school, what happens? In schools, usually teachers will not encourage much to ask questions. But what do they do? They ask students to read, write. What is happening? So the right brain activity is going down, left brain activity is increasing. So what is happening? School children, all the time, they will be writing, reading. What happens with that? The creative power has gone down. That is the reason why very few students will dare to ask questions. It is not that it is not there with them. It is because of constant practice from the childhood. It is in our hands. You know, this is what is by Lamarck principle. Lamarck said, you use it or else you will lose it. It is like a muscle. You know, all the bodybuilders will try to build their body. They will do exercise for months and years, they will build body. If they stop doing exercise, what happens? The entire muscle goes down. It is true with our brain too. You use it, it sharpens. If you stop using it, it goes down. That is the reason why people with highly active brain do not get Alzheimer's at the later stages. Alzheimer's is a memory deficient disease, amnesia, loss of memory. People who lead sedentary life, inactive lives, they are very much prone to Alzheimer's. So because the moment you start using it, it enhances its capacity. You stop using it, it loses it. I told you at the beginning, the brain capacity memory is 2.5 petabytes, a million times of gigabytes, which is very powerful thing. Now, coming back to the one, so cerebral cortex, give me a second. So cerebral cortex has got two hemispheres, left hemisphere and right hemisphere. Left one will be controlling reading, writing, arithmetic and mathematics skill. The right one has got creative visualizing things. So all the creative people, artistic people has got very, very highly active this right brain thing. Leaving this, there are a lot of things out there which are controlling our body movements and everything, body sensations. What happens in cerebral cortex is, see, information going to the brain is called as sensory information. The neurons which carry information to the brain is called as sensory neurons. Brain processes it and then it reacts by sending information to this peripheral parts, and the neurons which are carrying information from the brain to periphery known as motor neurons. Think about this. When I am teaching, you listen, you see. So all the sensations through the eye and ear goes to your brain. That is carried by sensory neurons. Optic neuron will carry the information to the brain. That is sensory neurons. Cerebral cortex and brain process that information. And if you wanted to write, the information should come from motor neuron so that it goes to your hand and you start taking pen and writing it. This is a motor function. The ability to write, the message comes from brain to your hand. From brain to periphery, it is motor. The information going towards your brain is sensory. This is the basic function of brain. The brain major function is sensory, integrative, and motor function. What does it mean? Sensory means whatever the information is taking towards the brain is sensory information. Integrative means brain will process the information. Motor means accordingly the information is giving to peripheral organs. Let me give you one practical example. You know, nowadays the cricket season is going on. When the batsman hits a ball, when it is in the sky, the fielder looks at it. That is sensory information. He looks, the ball is there. Now the brain will process the information and tells him, so you need to run at this speed and you need to stretch your hand so that the ball comes there. And then body will start running, stretching that hand. So that information processing occurs at this centers, cerebral cortex. And the motor neurons will carry the information to our skeletal muscle so that the fielder starts running it. Exactly, he goes where the ball is falling, stretches his hand, takes the catch. All these things happens in fraction of seconds. That is the reason why I told you the neuronal information velocity, the neural transmission velocity is 50 meters per second. In 1 second, it travels 50 meters. Our height is only 1.5 meters. So that is the velocity of neuronal communication. And all this process majorly takes place at this cerebral cortex. That is the reason why cerebral cortex is known as seat of intelligence, seat of alertness and everything. The other thing, from the cerebral cortex, there will be a lot of neurons coming to the peripheral parts. There are two different tracks are there, pyramidal tracks, extra pyramidal tracks. Now the reason why they are called is, some of the tracks from the cerebral cortex will be coming like this. Tracks are nothing but neuronal fragments. They will be coming like this. Now, when you see them, the appearance will be like pyramid. Hence, they are known as pyramidal tracks. Now, some of the other tracks will be coming normally. They are not with this pyramid. Hence, they are called as extra pyramidal tracks. So there are two different kinds of tracks which are coming from cerebral cortex. Some of the tracks collectively combines, and appears as pyramid in shape, hence they are known as pyramidal tracks. So this is how they will look. The other one will be out of this pyramidal tracks, hence they are called as extra pyramidal tracks. Now, the pyramidal tracks are responsible for our voluntary movements. If I want to move my hand, it is because from the pyramidal tract, the nerve response is there, I'm moving it. All the voluntary functions are under the control of this pyramidal tracts. Whereas extra pyramidal tracts will control involuntary movements. Involuntary movements means, you know, during night times or some of the people, when they sit, they will be constantly moving their leg or they will be constantly moving their hand with pen. That is involuntary. They will not be doing purposely. It just goes on like it becomes habituated. That is called involuntary movement. Some of the people will be moving their leg continuously. That is involuntary movement. That kind of involuntary movements are under the control of this extra pyramidal one. Whereas pyramidal one will control voluntary movements. Now, a lot of tracks are there which are coming from the cerebral cortex. The tracks will communicate with all the body parts as well as with the rest of the brain parts. If the damage to the tracks has occurred, that results in a kind of neuronal diseases. You know, in Alzheimer's, some of the tracks are damaged. That is what results in loss of memory. So cerebral cortex, a lot of things are there. And that cerebrum, based upon the location, it is classified anatomically as frontal cortex. This region is known as frontal cortex. And after that, you have parietal cortex or parietal zone is there. The backside is known as occipital. The sides is known as temporal. It is based on its anatomical position. The entire, see, this one is entirely covering the brain. It covers all, in the brain, 85% is of cerebral cortex or cerebral. So this is about brain anatomy and physiology. See, I have given you what is required for you, what all the important things are there. There are so many anatomical parts are there, physiological responses are there, but brain things are a little bit fuzzy. Completely, they are not explored. So hence, I have given you the important things. Let me repeat this again.